All right, ladies and gentlemen, yes, I'm a bit like the Renegade Master. I'm back once again, giving you a little bit of ill behaviour. So, in this video, I've got some tunes from Karmic Power Records. We have, on the right-hand side here, a track entitled She Said, which is by Sharm, which is spelt S-R-R-M-N. I hope I've done that, pronounced that correctly. We've got the Club Instrumental Mix. On the other side, which is the left-hand side, we have, where are we, Speed Up. It's a track called Speed Up, and it's by Grand Gyro. So, without further ado, what I'm going to do here is form a very long mix. Now, these two tracks are very deep, and they've got a lot of vibe to them. But what I want to try and do is form some kind of mix where it's almost like you could do even like a 64-bar mix or a 32-bar. But I'm going to use a loop, and I'm also going to be using some effects as well. So let's just play Speed Up a little bit. Now you'll get an idea, hopefully, of the two tracks. They're really nice and similar kind of feel and energy to them. Really nice bass line to this. This is Speed Up, both from Karmic Power Records. There will be a link in the description that will take you to Karmic Power Records. And as ever, a big thank you very much to the Karmic Power Records crew for letting me use your tunes. Loving it. Okay, this side we have She Said. Starts off straight away with this kind of old school 90s Chicago bass line. Loving it. Okay, so what I'm going to do first of all, I'm using the XZ. I'm just going to 4-bar loop, okay? Or, sorry, 4-beat loop, I beg your pardon. I'm going to press the +2, so now it's 8 bars. Now, at the moment, I'm not using Rekordbox software, I'm just using the files, okay? So just leave that. As soon as I start it, it's just going to carry on doing its loop. Alright, now this is where we can start really using the effects to the best of their ability. Now, I'm not so much an advocate, I'm not really for or against using loads of effects, but it's like anything, right time, right place, and it can sound brilliant. Now, if you're going to do a long transition where you're just mixing in the beats of two tracks, not necessarily the bass lines, melodies or whatever, let's say the outro of a track, just the beat is maybe 32 bars and the intro of another track is say 16 bars, then if you're just going to overlay those beats, it may be in time and in phrase, but it may sound a little bit boring. So adding effects will just make it sound a little bit more interesting, which is what we want. All right, so speed up. Okay, let's put it forward. Now, as well, you know, I could use the loop feature if I had Rekordbox engaged and quantized, but because I haven't got that, I'm going to use the 4-beat loop and then just double that. Maybe not there. Actually, yeah, maybe that. Now straight away, I've doubled it. So I've gone from 4 beats to 8 beats, which is 2 bars. believe it or not, even though it sounded relatively simple, there was quite a lot going on there. So if we go back to this loop, we listen to that. Now I've got the sweep mode on, and what that does is it starts to cut out some of the sound. So let's just start that. Now what I tried to do was almost act like I was a computer program. So what I did is I set the sweep at a certain level, left that run, I think it was for 2 or 4 bars, then turned it down a bit more and let it leave run in its sort of circle for another 4 bars maybe, and then turn it down again. So if you're a producer, most of the time what producers, what they won't do is just like chuck sounds all over the place, random sounds all over the place. What they'll do is the sounds that they put in will have structure. So for example, they could have, say, a beat with a kick with a certain sound for maybe 8 bars, and then change it slightly for another 8 bars, change it again for another 8 bars. So even though you may not think and you may not hear what's going on, it's almost as like it's a natural kind of progression. It's almost as though it's meant to be like that. So the listener just hears a track, but the producer who's made it knows that there's structure behind what they've made. So if I show you again without using the right hand side, so if you get them there, yeah, maybe it was 2 times. Oh no, actually maybe it was 4 times. And now we'll turn it down. There. And you leave it like that for 4 times, 4 rotations. Now like that. There. On the other hand, we can do, well, not on the other hand, but on the other side then, we could do something similar by adding the track. So let's go to low, and again I'm using the sweep. So let's just make sure we've got our loop on this side. So have a listen. Bring it up. So really what I was trying to do, and I'll do it again, is as I'm taking away one side in phrase and in time, I'm bringing the other one in. So it's almost as like it's, if you can imagine a pyramid and there are two people, there's one person walking up the pyramid and the other one's walking down the pyramid. So the track that's leaving the mix is the person walking down, and the person that, of course, is bringing, or the track that's in the mix is coming into the mix, is the person walking up the pyramid. So hopefully what I try to do, and I'll do it again, is as I'm bringing one in, I'm taking one out, but I'm doing it in steps. So if we start that again. There, so I've got that going. I've got that going. So let's just play it to begin with, the speed up by itself. So give it sort of 4 rotations, 4 bars. This one in. back at the end to just wrap it all up. So really, again, with mixing, if I was to, I suppose in a way, if someone asked me, what is it about putting two tracks together? What's one of the most important parts? And I would say it's the timing, because you've got to remember that 99% of dance music is in phrases. A general kind of radio friendly track, which is 3.5 minutes, you're looking at 2 and 4 bars. But most of the time, people like you and me, if you're watching this video, you like the extended versions, which is more like 8 and 16 bars. So you've got to try and have that in your mind. You've always got to think in 8s and 16s, because generally that's how tracks are made. All right, I hope that's a bit of a help here, bit of a random kind of video, but don't forget, check out the link in the description if you like these sorts of tunes, and go and check out Karmic Power Records. I must admit, this tune here, She Said, it's very reminiscent of sort of like, you know, 90s sort of deep house music. Loving it. Practice and enjoy. Thank you.